Hey guys, this is David Kwon, and welcome to an hour of Kwonmunism number 5. This is where I get dressed up. I mean, not usually all dressed up like this, but I wear a tie. That's the most important part. I wear a fancy tie that's been handed to me by my dad because he's a pastor and he has a lot of ties, and I kind of stole all his favorite ties from him, and I like to wear them sometimes. And what better occasion than to do it in front of a camera? So I wear a tie and I talk in front of the camera for about an hour, a little less, a little more. I'm never exactly exact on that, but this is where I just get in front of the camera and just talk about a whole bunch of different things. So this past week, a lot has happened, and I know I'm supposed to be doing this every Saturday. I promised that, but this Saturday I do have a great excuse. I was kind of busy. I had to go do something. And definitely, that was a really interesting thing, so I will definitely make a video about what I did this past Saturday. But that's a separate video. It's going to be really interesting. Something that happened in New York City that was awesome. If you follow me on Twitter, you know exactly what I did on Saturday, but that's okay if you're not. So anyway, yeah, our Kwonmunism number 5, lots to talk about. Let's begin with comments on my videos. And for that, I actually need to sit down and read from my computer, so let me get close to you guys. Show you my wonderful face. This is as good as it gets, folks. I mean, I got my suit jacket on, got my tie that I stole from my dad, and I got my hair did. So, this is as good as it gets. I know, this is as good as it gets. But anyway, let's get on to the comments I received on my videos this week. I received a good amount of comments. And a lot of them were interesting, but I had to pick out the ones that I thought were the most interesting to me. So let's do it. The first video I want to talk about, the first comment I want to talk about was on a video. And this is a long title I made for my video. And the long title, I think it was kind of worth it, but at the same time, the title is super wordy. But this is the video in which I titled, How YouTube and YouTubers Can Censor Themselves, and why it's dangerously wrong. And I talk about, you know, the systems in place with YouTube comment section that makes it so that we end up censoring ourselves. And I don't think that's right. And Brent Blogs made a comment on that video, and I thought it was a really great comment. This is what Brent Blogs says. The problem is that the internet wasn't a big commercial when it started. Now it's a big money machine. And as soon as you start involving money, you introduce owners. And those owners make the rules. And those rules are created to boost advertising revenues, create content monopolies, etc. That's where censorship comes in. That's also why Google ranks pages the way they do, etc. The internet is now, as all other things are, run by capital. That is all. And it's a really great point. Before I make any further comments on this comment, I do want to just make a plug for Brent Blogs. Brent Blogs makes awesome blogs. He makes great videos on his YouTube channel, and he's a really great guy to watch and listen to. If you like funny stuff, if you just, you know, like watching YouTube just to kill time, go check him out. This is the link. Go click on this link and check out Brent Blogs and watch some cool videos. So that's my plug to you. Great guy, and definitely a great comment. And I pretty much agree with just what he said in the comment there, except what I would add is that this isn't my issue with the way systems are now. It's not really just about the fact that the internet is a big commercial thing. You know, magazines are big commercial things. Newspapers are big commercial thing, and that, you know, that's a problem in itself. That does mean that the people who are behind the newspaper and behind magazines, people who are behind controlling the content, will end up censoring content for profit. That does end up happening, sure. But my big issue with, you know, the systems in place is that it's done by computer algorithms. So it's not done by human decisions, but rather it is totally based on what things we click on. And when it's based on that, it really does create this, what is called, Eli Pariser called filter bubbles. And it's really hard to get out of that bubble, because you're going to only get information that is comfortable and you like to you, because that's what creates money, that's what you want to click on. So That's really the problem. The computer algorithms in place who don't have human decisions to say, hey, I really like this. I'm going to share it with you. And, you know, humans have different opinions. If what you like, you know, the content that you like may not necessarily be the content that I like or that I agree with, which is why content being controlled by people in control of it, that's I'm okay with that, actually, even though there's a profit motive behind that. But when it's a computer algorithm that happens, this whole picture is a totally different picture. And that's one thing that we really need to think deeply about. And I'll make another video, actually, in the future, in which I talk about how do we combat this kind of filter bubbles that exist in this current internet culture. But that's a future video that you can look forward to. The next comment comes from my video, what can you achieve with a social work degree? In this video, I talk about various ways you can use your social work degree to achieve whatever. And I got a comment from First Merit Lee. I don't think he or she makes any videos, so I'm not going to link his channel here. But he makes a cool comment. He says, great video. I'm currently a BSW student in Chicago. I think we as people should care about the society and defend many people with the issues that categorize race, class, and gender. Thanks for the comment, and thanks for watching my video. Yeah, that's one aspect of social work for sure. We do, social work is geared towards working for people who are the most vulnerable populations, the people who are the most voiceless, the most ostracized, the most discriminated con. And usually, that is, you know, in the society, that has a lot to do with class, race, gender, sexual orientation, and many other intersections of personal identities and such. Really important, but social work does go beyond that also. This profession goes way beyond, it's a huge field with lots and lots of multiple paths to take in, and I think that's a great thing. And good luck on, you know, obtaining your BSW in Chicago. Chicago has a really great social work schools, just like New York, so good luck on that. Thanks for the comment. Next comment comes from the video, An Atheist Reads the Holy Bible, New International Version, Genesis 25-26. And the comment comes from Alpha Dog Omega Dog. And this person says, I'm glad you're reading this. Just don't stop with Genesis and think you've read the Bible. Skip over to the New Testament where the real action is. That was his first comment, and I actually responded with my own YouTube comment and saying, you know, I just asked him, you know, you do realize, you know, that this is not the first time I'm reading the Bible, or that is that what you're assuming? So the Alpha Dog Omega Dog responded, no, just every time I read it, I learn something new. So even if you have read it several times, there is always a chance for something there to touch your heart. 4 isn't enough to really catch some of the deeper themes. On YouTube, I've seen so many try this and give up into interminable battles and kings of Israel in 1st and 2nd Chronicles and 1st and 2nd Kings. So, that's the comment. Thanks for the comment. I have to say, you know, I mean, this is the fourth time on doing this on YouTube. This is the fourth time that I'm reading from front to back. But as a pastor's son, of course, I become more exposed to the Bible than just those 4 times, of course. But yeah, it is a good point that the more you read the Bible, the more you find stuff that you didn't realize before. In my case, it actually is worse for a Christian because I start discovering things that I find even more problematic with the Bible. As the more I read it, it's just like the more I read it, I'm just like, I haven't actually considered this, and this is really problematic. So the more I read it, the more problematic I find. So that's an issue. And I, you know, before I started doing this YouTube project of reading the Bible in front of a camera and making comments, I didn't realize that so many other YouTubers have done this exact same thing before. Of course, why not? It's the thing to do. But I do realize that a lot of YouTubers who did this kind of project did stop at, you know, in the middle of First and Second Chronicles or First and Second Kings, the Bible does get boring and pretty ridiculous, I know. So I know it's going to be kind of a struggle to get past some of the books in the Bible, such as Numbers and Deuteronomy, which definitely are. It's going to be a struggle to get past all that and to get past Hosea and Josiah and all that. But it's going to be interesting. I really find interesting that a lot of people, a lot of Christians who respond back to me in these videos think that the real action is in the New Testament. That's interesting. They just want me to skip reading the Old Testament and go right to the New Testament. And I don't know what the assumption is there. Do they think that I'll just suddenly turn into a Christian once I start reading the New Testament? That's interesting. I don't know why I keep getting that that comment so often. Like, hey, stop, you know, I think it's awesome that you're reading the Bible, but just skip over to the New Testament. You don't really need to go over the Old Testament, or you can go after you talk about the New Testament. That's interesting kind of comment that I've been receiving same general comments like that. Really interesting. Don't quite understand it. I do know, though, once I get to the New Testament, I do expect I'm going to have quite a tough challenge, because the thing about New Testament is one verse or two verses, there's so much stuff to talk about in like a couple of verses. So it's going to be really slow going once I get to the New Testament. I feel like books with four chapters is going to be like multiple videos, simply because there's so much stuff to talk about with each individual verses. But that's going to be way in the future, because I'm still in Genesis. I'm still talking about Genesis chapter 30. So it's going to take me a long time to get to the New Testament. So, but I do think I'll get there. I'm going to stick to this as much as I can. So that's going to happen. And this now is already 12 minutes, so I'll be continuing my hour communism in the next video.